Today was going to be a little bit of a technique video for me on spray fixative over charcoal and in graphite. And you'll see here, here's three pieces that I have done. And the problem a lot of times I have is when I spray on a spray fixative, it changes the values of my pencils. A lot of times getting rid of the subtleties that I've worked so hard to get in there. And it's always been a huge frustration of mine. And I think I'm still experimenting with different ways. But one of the ways that that I really like, and I saw a video, and it was a Winsor Newton video a while back. And what they did is they put down they used a 2B pencil, and they did a block of black, you know, one here, and they covered the whole thing with one layer, and then did a spray fix, blocked one side, and then did a layer over the whole thing, blocked one side, spray fix, did a layer. And that spray fixative, because it kind of locks the charcoal and the graphite in, you're actually putting another layer over the top as you're layering. So you're layering spray fixative pencil. And the one thing I realized is what I really need to do is my values need to stretch over the whole value range, or at least as much over the whole value range. If I'm using a toned paper like this, I'm not going to get a white, so I'm automatically starting at a 10%, let's just say, and I'm not going to get those total whites unless I use a pencil of some sort like this to get that white. And you can see the differences there, the white versus the charcoal versus this particular colored pencil paper. Very different. One's warm, one's a little cooler. So paper being on the warmer side, pencil being on the cooler side. So that's always can always cause a problem with your work too. In a thing like this, where the whole piece has a general warm look, and now you're going to kind of put in a pencil, you got to really be careful with that. So what I do to stretch that value range is I do the spray fixative thing. So I'll do a spray fixative over the top, and then I'll come back in, and a lot of times I'll come back in with this particular pencil. I really like this. I don't even know how to say that. The Quinchen permanent color. It's a black, 000 black. It works really, really well. But I'll also come in with a standard 2B, my 2mm 2B that I like so much. So what I'm doing is I'm going to push the values, the dark values. And by pushing the dark values, I automatically get a heavier contrast on my light values. And my light values are perceived to be lighter because my darks are darker. And it helps to get back those subtleties that I have. And you can see even on this particular piece here where, you know, I love all these little subtleties that I'm getting in here. Just shapes and stuff. And this is an overall dark piece. And I wanted it to be dark like this, you know. And so I've gone in now at this point, you can see the warmer whites that I've put in there. Sometimes I'm okay with it. Sometimes I'm not. It all depends. But I've went in with this one and I just started throwing in some highlights here and there. Those little specular highlights. And I'll continue to go. Even when I look at this here, I want to maybe hit a little bit more on the shoulder here. A little highlight here. Wherever I think the light is going to hit, I'm going to get a little bit of a specular light. And sometimes I'll just throw a random dot, you know, where I think it could pick up a highlight, pick up a specular highlight. So I'll go through this. And I've already started pushing back my blacks. You can see this is a nice dark color. Same with all this through here. It's nice and dark. And so I've already begun the process of pushing this one back. This one here, you can tell right through this area here, I started that process. And even in the eyes here, you know, but here's where I look at this and I go, okay, I could add in some little blings, some little, just hot highlights just to give it a little bit of depth, a little bit of interest too. I mean, sometimes it just, those are the little things, you know, when you look at that, at pieces, and you see those little bangs of the specular highlights, you just go, that's so cool. And I'm trying to be, you know, so see how that's kind of going in a line, and so that, because that's how light's going to hit. It's not going to be all over. You're going to get that, the swath of light, if you will, especially in this one where you can tell the light's just kind of going across. So you're going to have these more in a row. They're not going to be like one here, one over here, one over here, one over here. They're going to be a little bit more centralized. And then here's this, with this, push this area back. Well, if the area is farther back, it might capture a little highlight across there. Maybe in there, you know, random little hits. Just look so cool. And these little, I mean, this is metal pieces. You know they're going to get some love. You know, you can see I've already done a little bit across here. You know, on this face, I probably could push and make it just round it off a little bit. But the key is adding the spray fixative. So once the piece is done, once again, I'll do a layer spray fixative on there. This is just the one I use. There's a lot of, the Winsor Newton makes a great one. It's just the one I use. And then I just start layering in. So I'm gonna put this piece away, but you can see just from messing around with some of those specular highlights, just how cool they look. You know what I mean? You know, and if it's too much, I'll take my little brush and I'll just take it, just to touch it. And that touch will just push that back a little bit. So this one here, I've just begun to kind of start on. Sorry, I'm going to sharpen this pencil. Yes, I use an electric pencil, but look at the length it gives me on that lead. So here I go. I'm going to start laying it down, and you can kind of see what that's doing. I'm getting a nice dark. You see that? Look at that. When I pull that dark down a little bit against his hand, it's going to push that hand out a little bit more. See that? It's all of a sudden you're going to get the shape of that hand. It's all because I'm pushing the values. Even that, look how much more this hand pops out now because of that. As long as it's nice and sharp, watch what it does to the eye. When I just touch with that dark, look at that, boom. All of a sudden that eye just really, really pops. You guys see that? Move it closer to the camera now, but look at that eye and the nose there. But you can also see through this area here how I'm starting to get that this arm is coming forward because I'm pushing this back. You know, and even where I've got this little bit, this other kind of invisible guy down here, if I come around this a little bit, just slightly, like how that shape pops out a little bit more. You guys hear that? It's the make sure that everything is clean, which is always a good point. Make sure your bottom is clean, or the paper that you're resting on has got a clean surface. But you can hear the different texture of the paper since I've went in and sprayed it with the fixative. Now there's a little more grip. There's a little more bite. Balance that eye's blackness. I'll probably put in a little bit darker. This little area here. Maybe a little bit here. The other thing I'll probably do is hit this mouth just a little bit. I'm going to resharpen my pencil here. Some of that darkness throughout the face a little bit, so it's not like, oh, a dark line here, dark line here, dark here. I'm gonna move that. It's kind of like painting, you know, when you paint, if you paint a red, or you know, you put a blue in the thing, you kind of move that color throughout the whole thing. And this is the same way. I know, yes, you're thinking about values and you're thinking about light, but you got to move that value, the value range, throughout the whole thing. Say it by just kind of putting that in the head, how it's kind of balance that out just a little bit. Just some little dark spots where the scales might be hiding and where the light can't get into, kind of thing, you know. And you can see here's that specular highlight. And I've went in with a teeny bit of white already on this one. You can see that through this area here. Let me pull this a little closer so you can get a little better view of that. But anyhow, I just it's the quick one, fixative. It's kind of part of my process. Once again, I take my image once I get it to a point where I know I'm not going to really be doing much erasing, because once you put that fixative on, it's going to be really hard to erase. So I get it to a point where I'm like, okay, I'm good with my value range. I know that I'm going to throw some charcoal white on top of it or not, but I know for sure I'm going to go in with a darker pencil, and I want to darken my darks, because by darkening the darks, I'm going to increase the value range, which means the lighter ranges, even though if they're not all the way on the white side, which you don't want anyhow, but even though they're not all that way, it's gonna stretch out that value range, and you're gonna get back some of those details that you had lost before. And you can tell on this guy here, you know, even though I wanted this really dark piece, I've lost some value range right in here, and I'm gonna need to figure out how to get that back. You know, because it's the shoulder. It should be something, and I had something in there, but as soon as it sprayed fixative, I completely lost it. So I got to go back in and figure out how I'm going to get that back. And I haven't figured it out quite yet, but I will. You know, it's a matter of experimentation. You know, I could go in and try to erase some of it, or even just get a harder bristle paintbrush and see, can I get any of that up? It looks like some of it's come up. See that? A little bit's come up. That's why I'd use harder bristle brushes as well as my soft brushes. But now that I got this, I'm like, okay, well, this is, what if I darkened this line right here and brought it up a little bit? Pull this dark around a little, maybe. And you can see it's experimentation. Be ready to ruin a few pieces as you're working. It's okay. Starting to push in a little bit, which is good, and I might be able to, with the light, you know, let's make this vein and stuff move down just a little bit using the white. It's really tough because it's gonna, like I said, these whites tend to shine a little blue, so bring them down, maybe hit like something there's picking up a nice little specular highlight there. Maybe if I can do that a little bit here with some lighter colors, it, once again, I increase the value range. Brighter brings it forward, which pushes everything back. You can see I'm already liking that better. You know, it's already rounding off a little bit. Not enough texture. It was like a big chunk of white there, so I'm pushing it back with my pencil. Push it back a little bit. So anyhow, push and pull. There you go. So I hope this helps anybody who's thinking about the process and how I personally work. And please push it as hard as you can. I could actually take this and start layering more and more on this background. And I could make this background super, super, super black. But I like the subtle gray of it. It's almost like he's kind of coming out of this misty scariness. So anyhow. Please follow and let me know if there's anything else you want to see. I think the next one I'm going to do is an Instagram how-to. Just as an artist, how you want to use Instagram. And that building a following isn't the easiest thing in the world, but there is some techniques that you can use that'll help you grow a little bit faster. You know, but it's one of those videos that's I'm going to be extremely honest with everybody. I'm not going to be that, you know, oh, get a million followers in 30 days. It's not going to be that. It's how do you work diligently and hard to grow your Instagram account with followers that that are engaged with you, that enjoy your work. So anyhow, till next time, thanks so much. Bye.